coastal cities like Charleston, Miami, and New Orleans, water is in their DNA. But as sea levels rise, city planners are looking for new ways to protect their residents and businesses. And they're finding inspiration from the Netherlands. For thousands of years, water control has been at the forefront of Dutch government policy. Yes, because a quarter of the country is below sea level. The Dutch realized it wasn't enough just to keep the water out. The city had to adapt and learn to manage water. Dale Morse spent decades working on water management as a senior economist with the Royal Netherlands Embassy. He now works for the Water Institute of the Gulf, which is based in Louisiana. It's so nice to have you with us.
Thank you for having me.
As you consult with coastal communities, what's the first thing you tell a city?
That their flood conditions are not unique. Sea levels are rising around the world. They're rising quickly along the U.S. East Coast and in the Gulf of Mexico. So the challenges are existential. They're very real. They're very present, and cities need to adapt. Waiting for the grace of God to save you is not going to work. People are going to die. Capital is going to be lost. Businesses are going to move away. It's a very serious threat.
Well, you sound scary when you're talking to people. It seems to me like you have to start with either embracing the philosophy of we're going to figure out how to live with and manage water, or what I think has existed heretofore, right, which is either we don't see it or we're just going to build a bigger wall or we're just going to push it out. Why is embracing the better philosophy than just either ignoring or trying to push the water away?
Well, I think if we try to ignore the water challenges these cities are facing, the economic loss and the loss of human life is going to accelerate, and it's going to become unacceptable. People will move. These cities will lose some of their vitality. These cities are on the water, along rivers, on the coast, because they're wonderful places. They're beautiful, so we want to live there. However, living near water brings these threats. So if we learn how to embrace the water, understand what the various types of flood conditions and causes bring, and then adapting to that, this will take some time, it will take some investment, but it's possible, and I think it's necessary.
The investment is not small.
The investment
managing
is not small.
Managing water is expensive.
It is. It is also expensive to spend $200, $300 billion a year of U.S. tax dollars to rebuild after disasters. And this is what's occurring. If you look at the trends of federal expenditure over the last 20 or 30 years, it has exploded upwards. And so we're paying for this one way or the other. So if we can make some investments to mitigate these risks, to allow cities and communities, large and small, along the coast, along rivers, to adapt, I think the economic benefits, the return on investment, will be quite positive.
Are you optimistic or pessimistic that cities are hearing and buying what you're selling?
I'm a little bit of both. I'm optimistic that more and more places are starting to understand their risks. I'm a bit pessimistic that they're not doing it quickly enough. The investment is lagging, and these kind of adaptations take a generation. So, you know, I'm hopeful that we're starting to adapt, but we're not making the investments quickly enough.
Is there anything communities or even individuals can do sort of as a first step? Or is it just, hey, it's a lot of money, long-term investment over a lot of time, and we're already late?
Everyone and every level of government has a role to play. So individuals at their household level, they can put rain barrels, green roofs, you can rain gardens, you can do a lot of different things at that small scale level. You can work with your neighborhood. And as you go out from there, you look at sort of restoration of the natural ecosystems and wetlands and dunes and ridges that mitigate surge. You can develop in places where you can store the stormwater, infiltrate the stormwater so you take the pressure off of your drainage systems. And in certain cities, big cities, Boston, New York, possibly around Hampton Roads, Miami, New Orleans, Houston, these essential places in the U.S. economy, you may have to look at perimeter protection, and that is costly, but the evidence shows, as in the Netherlands, the investments pay for themselves over time, for sure.
Dale Morse, nice to have you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.